And so to the final. Cuba's Idalys Ortiz went for gold against former world champion Mika Sugimoto. It was the 22-year-old Cuban who'd beaten Tong in the semi, and now she had to get beyond another much-fancied opponent. It was close-fought and exhausting, and neither judoka could register a score. And when the golden score period was over, the judges had to call a winner. Ortiz got the decision and became an Olympic champion. So the gold went to Cuba's Ortiz, Sugimoto had to settle for silver, and the two bronzes went to Bryant and Tong.
It's every athlete's dream to have a gold medal, and it's an amazing feeling that I really have no words to describe. I don't know whether to cry, I don't know whether to smile, I don't know whether to laugh. I can only say I feel amazing right now.
No sé si llorar, no sé si reírme, no entiendo, pero creo que me siento muy bien. Bueno.
I'm practicing judo since I was 10 years old, and ever since then my dream was to be a gold medalist at the Olympics, and today I finally managed this. So for the next 4 years I hope to maintain my level and carry on doing what I love.
Campeona olímpica y espero que en los próximos cuatrenios poder mantener el resultado. Y bueno, es todo lo que me queda por decir.
As we have fought each other so many times, so I just thought I'd keep going and keep going. And I was thrown, almost thrown sometimes, but I just kept going, and this is it.
The Olympic judo moved on to the medal stage for the men's heavyweight, 100 kilos or more. In the first of the bronze medal matches, Ihar Makarau from Belarus faced Germany's Andreas Tolzer. 32-year-old Tolzer from Bonn pinned his opponent for the required 25 seconds to score the ippon and claim his first medal at this, his third Olympic Games. In the other bronze medal match, Brazil's Rafael Silva fought South Korea's Kim Sung-min. The fight was won and lost because of a penalty point awarded in golden score time. It wasn't a classic way to win a medal, not that Silva was complaining. And so to the final. The French fans inside the Excel Arena had been expecting nothing less than gold from Teddy Riner. He fought Alexander Mikhailin from Russia. It was Riner's fifth fight, and he was yet to be fully stretched. Once again in the final, his opponent couldn't get to grips with the 2-meter-4 Frenchman. The match was won on Warazari, the second highest score, courtesy of accumulated penalties against the Russian. The crowd perhaps hadn't seen the best of Riner, but his passionate supporters didn't seem to care. An utterly dominant performance by the giant Riner, and at just 23, he's likely to be around for some years to come. And so Riner took the gold, one of seven French medalists in judo. Mikhailin collected silver, and the two bronzes went to Tolzer and Silva.